try it. You'll kill yourself.
And it's worth it. Look at the way everybody's watching it.
You know why Heather's watching.
If I make it, she'll know who I am.
Okay, let's pay up before the lifeguard gets back from the chore. Thanks. You didn't bet me, did you?
No, I just want you to sign it. Your autograph will probably be worth more than the bill someday.
Right after I win the OP Pro, which, thanks to your friends, I can now afford to enter.
And why don't you try getting a sponsor, huh? Instead of gambling for your entry fee?
That wasn't gambling. It was an exhibition, and that was your price of admission.
Look! There's some kid out there.
What's he trying to do?
Hey, get away from there! Hurry, think about it!
Summer, when you park on top of a steep berm, you gotta pull the parking brake. We covered that in rookie school.
I know. I guess I was just in such a hurry to back you up, I forgot.
Don't forget again.
Look, Midge, I tried to stop him, but...
Unfortunately, there was nobody there to stop you. These kids emulate you, man. There's a responsibility that goes along with that. If I ever catch you surfing in a restricted area again, I'll ban you from every beach in L.A. County. You got that?
Yeah, I'm under the pier at Tower One. I'm in the water. You can't miss me. What, do you think the rules apply to everyone but you?
Look, I'm not the one who forgot to set the parking brake.
Yeah, I know. It's not your fault. It's just that if you hadn't been surfing under the pier, none of this would have happened.
Look, I'm surfing in the OP Pro next Saturday. Why don't you come? Maybe you'll see me in a better light.
Well, I'd have to check my schedule.
Well, if you can, I think it'll be worth it.
All right, come on, let's go play.
Let me tell you what I'm gonna do.
Let me tell you what I'm doing. Street Fighter 2, man, I'm gonna pound you into oblivion.
What are you doing shooting the pier?
Haven't you ever done anything stupid to impress a girl, Dad?
Yeah, once or twice, but it was never worth it.
Heather is definitely worth it.
She just doesn't know Hobie's alive.
He almost wasn't. Hey, look, I gotta go back to work. Stay out of trouble, huh? I want you home by 6:30.
Can I spend the night at Landon's?
Absolutely not. I want you home, washed and ready for dinner at 6:30.
Come on, let's go.
Where?
Wherever they're going.
Come on, man. Do it. Do it. Dig, dig.
Hey,
come on. Come on. Go side kick.
sponsor, huh? You are, Tony boy.
Oh, boy.
Let's go in.
It's a liquor store.
It's got video games. They want kids in there.
I gotta get home. I'll see you tomorrow, okay?
Okay. See you, Landon.
Hey, never reach him when I'm playing, man.
Honey, what's wrong?
Ma, you know that novel that starts, it was the best of times, it was the worst of times?
Yeah, I think that's the story of my singing career.
Well, today I messed up in front of Mitch. And then, like, a second later, Jimmy Slade asked me to go out with him.
Well, that's too bad, and congratulations.
Every time there's a cute guy around, I can't even concentrate.
Well, honey, that's a problem, because Mitch is your boss.
Not Mitch. I'm talking about Jimmy.
Oh, Jimmy. Oh, Jimmy. Well, yeah, but, you know, Mitch is pretty cute. Is he seeing anybody?
I don't know.
Could you find out for me, huh?
No way.
Oh, come on, way. Come on.
Ma, how come every time we have a conversation about me, it ends up being about you?
Oh, honey, I'm sorry. You're absolutely right. I am so sorry. Come here. Let's talk about you. Come here. Come here. All right, I want to hear all about you, and I want to hear about the best of times and your date with Jimmy.
Okay, well, okay. He invited me to this major surf competition on Saturday.
Ooh.
Yeah. And since he's only seen me in my lifeguarding suit, I think I'm going to buy a new bikini.
I saw a really cute one on the pier this afternoon. Now, let me see. Now, I've got about a half an hour before my shift starts, so what do you say?
Well, are you going to change your clothes?
No. When I start singing at that club instead of serving drinks, honey, I'm going to buy myself a gown. Come on, let's go.
You win.
Yeah!
All
right.
That was pure luck. I want another game. Hey, end of the line, bud. It's my turn to play the new champ.
Let go of me, man.
Hey, you guys, come on.
Hey! Guys, come on, knock it off.
You're really good.
Thanks.
Aren't you the kid who tried to surf the pier today?
Yeah, I would have made it, but I hit some kelp. I'm Hobie.
I'm Heather.
Nice to meet you.
Now get outside and cool off.
Hey! Okay, little champ. Let's see how good you really are.
All right. Are you ready?
Mrs. Thompson, this is Mitch Buchanan, Hobie's dad. I'm fine, thank you. Is Hobie there? No, I just thought he might be there because he was with Landon at the beach earlier. No, that's okay. I'm sure he'll turn up eventually. Thank you. Bye.
Damn it! What? Oh.
Hey, Dad, sorry I'm late. I'll go wash up for dinner.
Whoa, Roadrunner, come here. Where you been?
At Landon's. So I lost track of time. Sorry.
Hobie, I just called Landon's. You weren't there.
I'm at Jason's. I was at Jason's.
You been drinking beer?
No, Dad. Honest.
I want the truth.
Dad, I wasn't drinking beer.
Where you been?
Playing Street Fighter 2. Dad, I kept winning. All these guys had their quarters lined up to play me, and Heather stood right behind me watching.
Heather. Okay, now it's beginning to make a little bit of sense.
I beat this kid named Andy, nobody likes. So I became kind of like a hero. But Andy got ticked off and threw this beer can at us, and it spread everywhere.
How old's Andy?
15, 16.
And he's drinking beer?
No, the video games are in a liquor store.
What?
Dad, chill out. You're raging before my eyes.
Hobie, if the video games are in a liquor store, you are forbidden to go to that liquor store from now on. Do you understand?
Dad, this is not fair. All the cool kids hang out there.
Hey, pal, you struck out twice. 3 times you're out of circulation for a week. You got that? Now you get upstairs, you take a shower, and you come down and you have your burnt dinner.
I don't want any burnt dinner. I don't want anything from you!
Could you please chew without smacking your lips? That's it. Strike three. You're grounded for the entire weekend.
That's not fair! I didn't even get a warning!
Never does any good to argue with the ump.
Why should you be the ump?
Because this is the home field and I make the rules. Now sit down, finish your cereal, and then go to your room and clean it.
We'll be right back. He is cute. I wonder who he is.
His name is Jimmy Slade. He just moved here from Camp Pendleton. His father's a Marine. He lives in a van and he used the beach hut as his address so that he could enroll at Malibu Beach High next semester.
And how do you know all the dish on him?
Information is everything.
That's true.
Hi. Excuse me, I couldn't help overhearing you guys. So my name's Summer Quinn. I'm gonna be going to Malibu Beach High this fall.
I'm Tiara English. This is Courtney Brimmer.
It's nice to meet you guys. Well, I better go talk to Jimmy. We have a date.
He's going out with you?
Yeah, some information to add to your files. Hey, you won. Congratulations.
Hey, Summer, you made it.
Yeah, this is really overwhelming. I mean, we don't have anything like this back in Pittsburgh.
Well, I told you it'd be worth it. Well, have a great time.
I think I better go see what's going on, okay? Looks like your information wasn't very accurate.
Bye.
Honey?
Mom, I am so stupid.
No.
You know, I thought Jimmy was asking me out. It was only to come and watch him surf.
Now, honey, I know it seems like the end of the world right now, but...
Mom, it's the end of my life, okay? Those girls are the most popular girls at Malibu Beach High. I totally humiliated myself.
Okay, listen, I've got a great idea, okay? Let's go get a couple of huge pieces of chocolate thunder cake, huh?
Chocolate cake won't solve anything.
No, no, no. Cottage cheese won't solve anything, but chocolate thunder cake? Whew, that does it all. Come on.
Wait a minute, don't leave yet.
It's Monday, I served out my sentence.
Yeah, I know you did. I just want you to promise me something.
What?
That you won't go back to that liquor store.
Fine, I won't go back. Are you happy?
Thrilled.
Are you gonna play today?
No, I hurt my trigger finger.
Really? How?
Surfing. Another hairy wipeout.
Do you want one?
Yeah, sure. Anyway, I was on my way to the beach. You wanna come?
Nah, I'd rather hang here with my friends. See you around.
See ya.
Front liquor on the strand.
Come on! Here come the cops!
Hey, knock it off!
All right,
break it up! Fun's over! Fun's over! Hold
Bless
on!
These punks! They broke my window!
You were out there first. Did you see what happened?
Well, I... Who started it? I want to know every detail.
Well, first Tony chose Andy off for throwing the beer last week. Then Andy said he was mad because I beat him at Street Fighter 2. And then they both started throwing things. It was outrageous.
Look, they're both being arrested.
Come on, let's go.
Take it easy.
Watch it.
I hear you saw what went down with me and that sleazeball Tony.
Not really, I didn't.
Yeah, you did. You saw it all. You saw Tony run out there and jump me for no reason.
But I...
And when the cops ask you about it, that's what you're gonna tell them, right? Right?
But I wasn't supposed to be there.
But you were there. And now you're gonna be my witness. Next time you play Street Fighter 2, it'll be with your elbow.
Blackballing us.
It's time to turn the water over to the swimmers.
What swimmers? There's no one here yet.
Yeah, well, they'll be here soon.
Summer, what is with you?
What do you care?
I thought we were friends.
Yeah, well, a friend doesn't ask you out on a date and then totally humiliate you in front of everyone.
What are you talking about?
The surf competition. We had a date and you took off with Daisy May.
You thought when I asked you to come to the contest, it was a date?
Oh, and is that so far-fetched that you would ask me out on a date?
No, it's just...
You're getting sand all over my tower. Would you mind leaving?
Hey, little champ. How you doing? I hear you've been talking to that creep Andy. And they're gonna tell the cops I jumped him.
I'm not gonna tell the cops anything. I didn't see anything.
Oh, really? Well, you know, Heather told me you saw it all. You see, I need you to be my witness.
Your friends can say what happened.
The police will believe you. You tell them you saw Andy trying to steal my board. But when I caught him, he attacked me first. We're clear on that?
Yeah.
All right.
Would you do me a favor? Finish this report and get it up to Lieutenant Holden.
Thanks.
Major. Hobie?
Hey, Dad.
What's going on?
Just waiting here. How's it going?
Busy. Something you want to talk about?
No, I just thought I'd wait here for a while.
Hey, Mitch, you have a minute?
Yeah, sure.
Hello, Hobie. How's it going?
Okay.
Good. Glad to hear it. Listen, you people have their ears to the wind. Heard any bluster about a fight yesterday outside beachfront? Look, a couple of teenage boys going at each other?
No, no, I haven't heard a thing. I'll ask around, though. What's the deal?
Well, each one says the other started it. Parents want to press charges, threatening to sue each other, threatening to sue the liquor store for having video games. It's a mess.
You know anything about that fight?
You made me promise not to go there.
Hobie was in that liquor store last week playing video games.
Hobie, you know a couple of kids named Tony Valentino and Andy Van Pelt?
I don't think so.
Well, that's good. You stay away from that place. There's nowhere to hang out. Listen, you hear anything, let me know, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, see you guys.
See ya.
You sure you don't know anything about that fight?
Why does everyone think I'm supposed to know everything? I wish you'd just all leave me alone.
Hobie.
I'll be at the beach.
Yeah.
you know there's no drinking of alcohol on the beach, and besides, you're underage.
Oh, not according to my ID.
Look, just put the tequila away and keep your phony ID in your wallet.
We won't go in the water.
Good, because drunks make lousy swimmers.
Aren't you the one that had that phantom date with Slade?
That was a misunderstanding. Don't let this be, okay? Take another sip of that margarita, and I'm gonna pour it out and cite you.
No, you won't. Look, you already made a fool of yourself at the surf competition. You don't want to do anything else to make more enemies. School can be a very lonely place when no one will talk to you. You don't want that, do you?
Just don't go in the water, okay? I don't want to have to pull you out.
I forgot your name.
Summer.
Oh, precious. Summer. I live on the largest horse ranch in Malibu. It has a private beach. The day you have to pull me out of the water is the day the ocean freezes over.
Come on, let's go. Don't go in the water, you're drunk.
I've got these boys to look after me.
Heather's going.
Really?
Tell me when she's close. Now.
So then Slade said I'm a much better surfer than he was
Hobie?
At my age. Hey, Heather. Want to build the sandcastle with us?
No, thanks. Tony wants to see you.
I gotta get home.
He said to meet him where the homeless sleep under the pier, or he's gonna come to your house. And he said to meet him alone.
I've got multiple victims caught in a riptide. I need immediate backup.
I just warned her not to go in the water.
Just like you had a date with Slade? You're a liar and everyone knows it.
She's telling the truth. The lifeguard warned her not to go in the water. I heard it. And we did have a date. I'm the one who blew it.
Looks like the ocean just froze over.
Now it's time for you to make up your mind whose side you're on. So what's it gonna be? Him or me?
I'm telling you, Mitch. I talked to the liquor store owner 10 minutes ago. Hobie fixed the description of the kid who witnessed the fight.
He was there, I swear, I've ground him for a year. Landon, do you have any idea where Hobie is?
My old man gave me this. You don't do what I say, you're gonna get it worse from me.
Those guys are after me.
It's okay. Hobie, I know you saw the fight. Everything's gonna be okay if you just tell the truth.
That's just it. I didn't see anything. I just told Heather I did so she would think I was cool.
It's okay, man. It's okay.
Again.
Now you're probably gonna ground me.
You are batting 1,000.
I don't get it. How come when you know something's wrong, sometimes you still do it anyway?
It's a good question. I think a lot of it has to do with peer pressure. Being afraid that you're not gonna fit in.
So how do you stop?
You gotta ask yourself a question. What's more important, that all my friends like me or I like myself?
Yeah, I guess friends come and go. But you gotta live with yourself.
Not only that, I gotta live with you.
Yeah, but parent pressure's a lot worse than peer pressure.
No way. Because whatever you do, I'll always love you.
I love you too, Dad.
Good. Because this is the last time you're allowed to boogie board for a month.